Joining us live now on the phone is Christy Rowe. She is the director of the Nevada Seismological Lab. Christy, thanks for joining us. Do we know anything else about the epicenter or how deep this earthquake was?
Yeah, thanks for having me. The earthquake happened a little bit north of Yerington on the Walker River, and it's not a very densely populated area, but it's part of our seismic zone along the Nevada-California border that has a lot of earthquakes. So far we haven't heard any reports of any injuries, which is really good news. An earthquake of this size could cause injury if it was in a more densely populated area, so we'll be keeping a close eye on it. We are actually right now deploying more seismometers to the region. There's always a possibility that you have a bigger earthquake. The odds of a bigger earthquake are slightly elevated after a moderate earthquake like this one. So we want to be ready for that.
And also just the fact that we've had, what, 9 or 10 aftershocks. That's
we're actually
pretty
at 11 now.
At 11. And so that's kind of positive in terms of, you know, reducing the possibility of us having a larger one after, correct? So because we're having
No, definitely not.
Or is it opposite?
Definitely not. No. So the little earthquakes, these aftershocks are so small that they do not actually change the likelihood of having a big earthquake. They don't relieve any of the stress. Yeah.
All right. So we now had 11 of those aftershocks. No. But it is good that, you know, I don't know about you, Christy, but we've heard from a lot of people that said they saw the shaking even in South Lake Tahoe. The bottles were rattling, but nothing actually fell off of the shelves. Right. What does that tell you about this particular quake?
That's appropriate to the size and location of this quake. We probably don't expect damage with a 5.5, but if it gets any bigger than that, that's when you start to see the potential for damage or injuries. So, yeah, we in Nevada, everybody, all the schools need to participate in the Great Shakeout. I know a lot of California schools do that, too. And so everyone needs to keep in mind where they live or where they work to have a safe place to drop, cover, and hold in the event of shaking. Obviously, the 5.5s are a great time to remind us of how to get ready so that we don't suffer injury or damage or loss when a bigger one occurs. And, you know, I know that your viewers and as well as us in the Reno area, we are always waiting for the day when that big one will come.
Yeah, absolutely. Christy Rowe with the Nevada Seismological Laboratory. Thank you so much for your time and your input.
Thanks for having me. And